think you'll go?
Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as I could have been. But still. Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone. Now is my chance. One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance.
Easy!
quite a carriage you got there. Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight.
How did you come by that?
Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach?
Of course.
All as expected.
What have you got yourself into?
Where's the rest? Search me. Search me?
We have an intruder! There! Now there's a suspicious
one. Hang on. Where's the rest? Search me? A half ton of lumber doesn't just walk off. Very good.
Bloody thieves.
Charming. Now to hide the body.
The police will deal with you.
You can't step on the street without the world crushing you or knocking you over. Next time, monster.
ready? Here I come. One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
I think I'll take to fatherhood like a duck to water.
What's that you said?
That's not to say you both have bad luck.
Thank you.
Amanda! Stop her! Stop her!
Miss Fryer?
Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square.
Here now.
Welcome, sir.
Your Highness, what a surprise.
Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth sees the Punjab replying with my... That was all I asked. You are...
I will do with that.
I trust you and John will enjoy the visit.
Beautiful day. Will she be able to see nothing?
That proved valuable.
Where?
I noticed Irene nodded.
He has other things to do.
A bit. You two get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow our personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation. Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily. I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
The father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green know? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
To Parliament, please, on the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
Why, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It needs to look so still that she'll sleep. Hello, I think it's her. But truly, took my brother away. I saw her 3 years before she died. Summer long since. Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh!
You remember?
The one about your parliamentary woman and I'm begging for scraps.
Please, sir. My be freedom. I am here to...
Do job. I shall tell you. You're the smile of the world. Simply blessed. The Sikhs deserve it. I hope you focus.
Thank you, Miss Fry, for forwarding my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad, broken even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
How's your brother? Not dead yet, I hope.
That's it. Yeah! Come on! Faster! Easy. Easy.
Stop! Stop! Remember your training and subdue her!
The shot's lined up!